Welcome back to Matt's Basement Workshop. Today's episode is sponsored in part by Highland Woodworking. Visit their website at highlandwoodworking.com. And also by Lee Valley and Veritas. Visit their website at leevalley.com. Hey everybody, welcome back to Matt's Basement Workshop podcast. It's a Tuesday and that means that it's a Try-It Tuesday. And for today's episode, I'm going to introduce you to the Kreg Multi-Mark. Now, I don't know if you're familiar with this. It's been out for a little while now. And this is a nifty little tool because it's a 3-in-1 marking device. And by what I mean by 3-in-1 is the fact that we can adjust this blade for 3 different positions. So we could have it as a depth device, much like we see it here. We can have it as a square here, or for 45 degrees. So regardless of which configuration you have it set up as, the Multi-Mark will really, really help you out in getting accurate results for whatever measurement you need. The one measurement that I prefer to use this for the most happens to be either, actually it's two, I like to use it as a square, or I like to use it in this where I can set up a depth. A lot of times I'll use this on my saws, especially my table saw, but I will also use it on my router because of the fact that I can adjust this up and down as needed, so I can make quick measurements real quick. So let's say I'm going to make 2 cuts on the saw and I want the first one to be, oh, let's say 1/4 inch deep. I can then set it for 1/4 inch and then I can quickly adjust it for the next one to be at 1/2 inch, and it's all with one tool and it's going to be exactly the same way both times. Now the neat thing, of course, is let's talk about the body here. We have this knurled knob, which as you saw has the 2 or 3 different positions that you can set it up on the body. There has the 2 on the front and then the 3rd on the back for the 45 degree. Has this nice little blade, and this is actually rather rigid, to be quite honest with you. I've been trying to flex it, but it doesn't want to flex very well for me. Well, maybe it just speaks how weak I am. But you have 2 different measurement options. You have inches on the front, which go down to 1/16 of an inch, and then you have centimeters on the back. So depending on which measuring increments you prefer, you have those options. There, as you can see, we'll come in kind of close here, the markings are very clearly printed on there. In fact, they're etched in more than anything else. They're not just simply drawn on there, which is really going to help you out, because if any of this ink starts to fade away, you still have the measurements themselves so that you can kind of feel for them. You can fill those in. And kind of go from there. That's something you don't see on a lot of measuring devices anymore. It's a hard plastic. I'm sure at some point, using it quite often as I've been using it, it's going to get nicked and dinged. So it might knock out the accuracy a little bit, but to be quite honest with you, I use this more for rough measurements than anything else. Nothing beats a really, really great accurate square, although this one does, since you have the 3rd option in there, versus just the square and the 45 degrees. Of course, as I mentioned, it has the built-in level, so if you're doing any carpentry work around the house, this will really, really come in very, very handy for getting reveals and then also making sure that you have the whatever you're working on nice and leveled out. And that actually will help you out with your tools too. If there's a reason why you need to have it level, you then will know. Now let's head over to the table saw, and I want to show you a quick setup of what I mean by using this as a depth gauge. You can usually use it this way, or you can put it in the square position, and you'll be able to dial in exactly how high or how low your saw is, whatever it is that you need to do. And you can do the same thing on your router table, or with your router, not necessarily just in a router table. So let's go ahead and take a look at that. So using the Multi-Mark to set my blade is really easy. And let's use the example of this rabbeted piece right here. Now there's 2 cuts we need to make. One is the height and then one is the depth of the fence itself. So let's set the height first. And that's really easy using the Multi-Mark. What we'll do is we'll loosen this knob right here. And then we're going to go ahead and, here, this will be the depth. We'll go ahead and put this in. We're going to set it right up against the shoulder on the inside, and then the body itself is going to set right against the edge of the piece. We got it where we want it. We just tighten it down, and then now our depth is set. So let's go ahead and we'll set it on the highest part of the blade. Of course, we made sure that the blade is the saw is not plugged in, and we'll go ahead and drop this down until it registers against the stop plate, the throat here, the throat plate, and there we go. Now it's exactly where we want it. The other set, the other measurement we need is we want to know how far over the fence needs to be so that we can get the second cut. So again, we'll go ahead and orient this. We'll loosen up the knob and we'll butt the body right up against it, and we'll put the blade right against the inside shoulder, tighten it down, and then now we know that when we put this in place, we can move the fence over until it butts right up against it. And there, now we've got it exactly where we want it. So when we make our cut, we have the right height, and then we have the right width for the proper cut as we run it through there. Now in this configuration, as you can see, I have it set up as a square. And one thing I like to do once in a while is I like to have layout lines so I know exactly where I want to, say, maybe put a groove or a dado. And you could do this with a square, but I think this one's a little bit easier because of the fact I can make such a quick adjustment to it. In this case, we have it set for about a 5/8 inch deep groove. I'll just put my pencil right along the edge there and I could draw the line. And then now, let's say I want that this groove that I'm going to cut to be 1/4 inch, so I pull the blade back about 1/4 inch, and then now I can just run a parallel line with it. I'll mark this so I know exactly what's being removed. And as you can see, I have those perfectly parallel lines, and they were really quick and easy to do because of the fact that I can undo this knurled knob, adjust it back and forth as needed. And as you can see, like I said, those markings are really clearly indicated, and they're not just drawn or painted on the fence itself, they're actually etched into it. So that makes a huge world of difference. But that's just another one of the really neat things I can do with this. And of course, if I wanted to, I can use it as a square this way. And like I said, I measured it and I made sure that this is pretty darn square, at least this particular one is. And of course, as I mentioned, it's plastic body, so it's easy to kind of ding it up a little bit, so it could potentially be an issue down the road. But you know what, I have a feeling this is going to last quite a while. So the Kreg Multi-Mark, nifty little tool, three marking gauges basically in one, the square, the depth gauge, and of course the 45 degrees on the back. Will it replace my high quality square? I don't think so, but I think I'm grabbing this more than I'm grabbing this, so that says quite a bit about it. I definitely enjoy using this, and thanks to the folks over at Kreg for giving us an opportunity to try this out. And like I said, we already gave away one on the show. So if you're just at all in checking it out, of course, I'll have links in the show notes to make sure that it's that much easier for you to find one. Nifty little tool, and I think you'd find it handy in the shop. So until the next time, straight grains and sharp blades. Take care, everybody.
Thanks for watching. For more information on today's episode, visit mattsbasementworkshop.com. And a huge thanks to our sponsors, Highland Woodworking and Lee Valley. Visit them today.